My mother was the strong one. You attach yourself to whoever has strength. And it was clear that she ran the family. I mean, that she could buy all these things like this. She could produce these terrible meals. The whole place was just filled with junk. I mean, there were stoves and things that didn't work. There were a mangle, you know, to iron with, sitting there in the kitchen. All these things were sitting there. There were pots and pans hanging on the walls, which were covered with fuzz and dust. This is a steel mill city. But they were all wearing sweaters. It was just crazy. And, you know, she would have a fire on the stove every day. Well, every other day. And so she had great bins of salt sitting there, and she would throw heap, you know, saying, you know, it's perfectly all right, don't worry about it, and throw salt onto the fire to put it out. And, you know, it was just weird. And even if they went out, say, they would go out for a drive someplace, and they would pass one of these places that had yard art. Yeah, by now, with the cat, my wife, and me, we go by one of these places, say, yard art, yard art. It's like, alarm, alarm. She would go in and want to buy a bunch of these things, and then she would usually say, oh, no, I don't need that. And he would say, go ahead, Helen, you know we can afford that. And he would encourage her. Maybe that was his way of trying to win her back. But it's clear that she was the power. She had the rule there. I remember when we were little kids, we were very religious. We had to, before we went to bed, we had to kneel down at our parents' knees and give a night prayer. One night, my mother was away, and so my father said, you can come and say your prayers to me. Well, of course, if you even put it in that terms, that means that the parent is in the position of the divinity. You can say your prayers to me. I said, no, I want to wait till mother comes home. And he says, no, you have to do this now. You have to go to bed. And I refused. And without realizing it, I clenched my fists. And he says, you want to fight me? Come on. I almost fainted with terror. I mean, he was so much stronger than I. And I knew he used to claim that when he and I would have boxing lessons, he was trying to teach me to be more like him. He'd say, if you hit Claire English, the kid you're having a fight with at school, if you hit him half as hard as you hit me, you'd win every fight. But somehow the thought that he was actually going to hit me just put me in an utter panic. I don't know what the hell I did.